come to me for honesty.
When I was much younger, yeah, I was attracted to video game characters. Now I don't care anymore. I am married. I don't look for attraction to a video game character. That's fucking lame. Cyberpunk. Oh, there's going to be mo-capped sex scenes. What? Am I playing a game to fucking jerk off the people fucking having sex? This is stupid. I'm playing a game to have a fun, interactive experience that has meaning and, I'm not playing it to see people fucking bone. I could do that at any point. I don't need to fucking buy a game to do it. You're taking the waifu thing way too serious. It's basically a Wii version of a celebrity crush. That's the thing. Crushes, in essence, crushes are incredibly immature. They're for people who are immature. They are. When I was young and I was a teenager, I had crushes. I haven't had a crush on anyone, since I was in my early 20s probably. I would say that was probably the last fucking time. It's something that you grow out of as you mature. But people on the internet love to act like it's a commonplace thing and it's like normalized okay behavior. That even if you have like a significant other, I still have a waifu and a crush and all that. It's fucking stupidity. That's called being incredibly immature. Alright. What's hilarious about all of this is that there's a bunch of people in the stream chat who understand and are like, okay, makes sense. And then there's other things here that people are saying, oh, that's so ridiculous, I don't understand. It's because you're not where I am yet in your life. You're not. You haven't reached the point where you're feeling like you want to move to the next stage of your life where things are more mature, where you have something meaningful like I have. You're not there yet. And I get it, because I wasn't there until the last maybe 2-3 years of my life where I realized, oh shit, things got to get better. This is stupid. You'll get there one day. Most people do. Some people never do. Some people never mature. Some people never get to that point in their head, and they're always this kind of like very ridiculous, immature, I gotta, that thing flies. It doesn't fly for me anymore. You know what I mean? When I'm playing Judgment, there's so much other cool shit to do in Judgment, right? Outside of that stupid stuff. But people still ask, Phil, are you gonna go get the simulated girlfriend? Are you gonna go to the hostess club? No! If I want that kind of stuff, I go do it in real life with my wife. I'm not gonna have stupid, who's your waifu in a game? I don't fucking need that. I have a real wife in real life. I don't have a fucking waifu. I don't need to have fantasy shit on the side. In fact, I hate to say it, if you have fantasy shit constantly on the side and you're married or you have a significant other, it probably means your relationship ain't so great and you're seeking out those kind of relationships elsewhere in the fantasy world. If you have a really robust, loving relationship, you don't need to seek that shit out in video games and fucking porn and all that other shit. It doesn't matter anymore once you have a significant other. You know what I mean? And so for me, I've definitely matured over the years. I've become a much different person than I used to be. All right? And I just don't care about that shit anymore. I'm not going to make that easy, low-brow, low-hanging fruit sexual comment to get a rise out of my audience. I'm not going to do that kind of style of commentary because that's not who I am anymore. I've definitely matured and changed over the years for the better. If someone sent me a waifu body pillow off Amazon, I would burn it or throw it out. I have a fucking wife. I'm not a loser who sits around with a fucking body pillow that looks like a fucking anime girl. I'm not some 15-year-old pimple-faced loser. I'm a 37-year-old married man, goddamn. I said, would you do at least one of the girlfriend missions? Each girl's unique storyline missions that are pretty funny. Don't worry, we won't tell Kat. I have no interest in them. Dude, I'm serious now. I'm going to be very honest, all right? Can I be very honest with everybody here for a minute? I'm 37 years old. I'm married, man. I'm a married man. I have no reason to have waifus. I have no reason to do romance missions in video games. I have nice romance in my real life. I don't need simulated fucking romance in my video games, okay? So I have no desire whatsoever to do stupid romance missions in a video game. Not in an RPG, not in a fucking Yakuza game, not in any game. I don't need to do romance missions. It's so ridiculous, you know? Yeah, at one point in my life, it was funny or fun to do that stuff. At this point, I think it's lame. It's cringy. I don't want to do it. It's like not interesting to me at all, okay? All right, okay. Dude, I still, to this day, I'll say it again, I don't understand this whole club system thing that they do in Japan. You go to a club, you pay money to spend time with a person. Like, you know it's not real. You know that's not a real relationship. You know that's not something that's going to become a real, you're not going to go on a real date with that person. You're just, the only reason they're spending time with you is because you paid money. That, I just don't understand it. You know what I mean? And it never gets to the point where, like, it advances to, say, you know, prostitution or something like that. You know what I mean? It's just you're paying to talk to a person. I so don't get that. Yeah, but I get that. But what if you, like, you have to know at some level it's not real. You know what I mean? Like, you have to know at some level the only reason that person's spending time with you is because you came into a club and paid money. Dating builds intimacy. Oh boy. This is fucking Persona 5 levels of weeb at this point. I'm sorry, but do I really want to date a virtual fucking girl in the game? No, I'm married in real life. I don't need to date a virtual girl in a fucking game, so that's something I will not be doing. How ridiculous. Sorry. I'm with you, Golden Cults. I don't know why men would go here, but again, it's a completely different culture. Sloppy Meat wants a few leg slaps. If I get frustrated tonight, I'll slap my leg, but that's when I do it, so. Oh my god, why do they keep zooming in on her boobs? Stop that. You fucking perverts who directed this game, man. Don't even hit it! Stop it! What's your problem? What the fuck, man? He's a perv. He's staring at those ginormous knockers. Come on, man. I'm actually a virgin. Hate Army General saying hate army shit to Hate Army. If your name is Hate Army, you're a piece of dog shit. Human piece of dog shit.
Fuck! Fuck me!
Oh, what a stud! I can't get enough of you, Jax.
What?
Tie you to the
a killer fridge that fucks disgusting. Sugar. Great.
Don't let her bind your arms.
No shit, she's gonna kill you.
Can't you see I'm trying? Open to suggestions!
Bring me to her sensor manipulator, quick!
How titillating! Rebellious dominant men really turn me on.
Oh my god.
I'll turn you on, alright? Just let me.
This is disturbing shit.
Oh, I love tough guys. I'm on fire.
Closer! I can't reach her.
Kill a stupid thing.
I'm trying. She's one strong ass bitch.
I'm at your service, sugar. Anything.
What are we doing? I can't do anything right now. Look, I'm not actually doing anything. What the fuck?
More skills will become available to you soon, but choose shock for now.
What? Now what? So we overcame the dirty talking fridge and now we can get our upgrade tree. What? What? Okay. Anyway, I received a dollar tip from a good Samaritan. And now here we go. It's a troll. Of course. So this good Samaritan, here's what you can do. All right? Here's what I'd like you to do. I'd like you to bend over and kiss my ass. Thanks. Okay, let's choose a skill.
You were fortunate enough to acquire about 50 grams of neuropolymer. I suggest exchanging this dose with lovely Nora for a new skill. You don't mind.
We're buying shock. Okay. That's it? I just look like I can do anything else, right? Switch to crafting?
Oh, how can I resist?
Oh my
now,
god,
let
this
me
stupid
show
thing.
You what I
can we tell
do
him to shut the fuck up?
Professionally, I mean.
Choose
I've seen
upgrades?
It. Literally. Crispy critters.
I am here to help you upgrade your red hot pocket rockets. And believe me, handsome.
Oh my god, can we shut this thing the fuck fancy. Up? It's obnoxiously bad. Shut up.
Responding window major.
Get rid of that glove, handsome. You don't need him anymore.
I can't even concentrate. I literally can't concentrate on what I'm doing. Because it won't shut the fuck up.
You want. Got a sword? A massive sword? Thrust it deep into my socket so I can make it sturdier and sharper.
Nora can up.
Okay, so now we can concentrate. So let's see here. Round attack, a crushing roundhouse blow starting and ending with the first target. Yeah, so what it is to select level or you're selecting the level of the attack by pressing right bumper and left bumper. Okay, so I guess you just install it, press X, so you can't do it higher level now. You just gotta do the basic level first. Okay. So what did it do? Did it up the attack level or did it give me a special attack? Complete? I'm just waiting for it to shut up so I don't have to hear it. I couldn't take it. I actually wanted to punch my fucking console for a second there. So, did it show up? It's still talking. Once it shuts up, I'll actually check this out again. Can I check out? Look, I can't. Arsenal upgrade, polymer upgrades for Charles. Like, let's take a look at Arsenal upgrade again. Did it shut up? It's not talking now, right? I think it actually shut up. So what do I have? The Swede and the shotgun. I don't know, because the game's not explaining anything. It's just doing stupid synth dirty talk. So I can't fucking figure out what's going on. By the way, it stopped talking. I can actually turn the audio back on now. For God's sakes. Okay. There we go. Can I hear again? Yes. Okay. So, Broseph, thanks for the super chat. No, the audio was not explaining anything. The audio was being fucking stupid, disgusting, and very distracting, and I hated it. That's why I turned it off, because I couldn't even fucking take it. And I don't know why they did that. A bunch of fucking idiots to put that shit in the game. Cooling cover, improved cooling system. Alright, thank God we survived that nonsense. Hopefully not everyone fucking is obnoxiously talking like that. I'll just fucking delete the game. I can't take that shit. That actually drives me nuts. I couldn't believe it. So, Broseph, thank you. Thank you for the super chat. Sorry, Broseph, that I muted it. If you'd like to hear that, you can get the game for yourself and you can dirty talk the fridge as much as you want. You know, maybe lick its icebox. Go ahead. I'm not doing that. Anyway, here we go. Now, what's hilarious is, you know, out of all the weird shit going on in this game, the one thing that morons focus on is this one moment that's absolutely obnoxious. So you walk into a room and there is a giant rectangular red metal box that looks like a refrigerator almost. All of a sudden, these robot tentacles come out of this thing. It starts pulling you towards it and it wants to kill you. It's trying to kill you. But they gave it a female voice that's basically saying sexual things to you. It's the weirdest thing. And I was like, what the? Now, originally, all right, maybe it's supposed to be scary. It's trying to pair this stupid, dirty-talking fridge with it trying to murder you. And it's obnoxious at first, but like, okay, whatever. But then what happens is you hack it or whatever, so now it's not hostile anymore. Well, this actually is supposed to be the unit that you need to interact with over the course of the game to do all of your upgrades. All right, so this is going to be upgrading your weapons. It's going to be upgrading your abilities. So it's very important that you learn how to use this thing. And it's got a unique menu system. It's a little different from other games. So you got to kind of mess with it a little bit to understand it. But as you're trying to sit there and interact with the thing for the first time, it continues to talk dirty to you. It's like, what the fuck? And it's so intrusive because, again, just like the other audio issues in the game, the fridge starts to talk. You're talking to the fridge. Your hand is talking. And it's just like this cluster conversation of shit. It's like, shut the fuck up. Let me just concentrate. I'm trying to learn the upgrade system. And you're trying to literally do things in the menus. And you cannot concentrate. Because it's like, imagine if you're in a room. And oh my God, something important is happening right now. I need to respond. And you got a moron here saying, meh, 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 meh. And on the left-hand side, you got someone saying, boo. And then in front of you, someone's dancing, saying, ha, 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 ha. So you got meh, 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 boo, ha, 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 ha. All around you're like, what? No, I didn't concentrate. This is important. I need to concentrate on this right now. That's what it feels like. I mean, I could care less what the fridge is saying to me. Just shut the fuck up. Allow me to just sit here and concentrate on my game so I can learn a critical thing. This is the thing. You need to learn this system to upgrade for the rest of the game. If I fuck it up now and I don't know what I'm doing, I might dump upgrade points and crafting materials into something that's not worth it. I need to concentrate. It's like the morons who made this game, and yes, I hate to say it, whoever made this part of the game are morons. You don't fuck around when you're trying to learn a critical piece of the game because then you could ruin the rest of the game for the player. It's moronic. It's idiotic. It's like they never played a game before. And it drove me nuts. So I muted all the audio. And what's hilarious is people are like, you see, Phil's muting the audio because the game's talking sexual to him and he can't take it. No, moron. You could join the moronic nature of the people who made this part of the game because you don't understand. I'm just trying to learn the game, especially when I'm doing it on a live stream. And this is going to be a playthrough that's public. This isn't me fucking around at home for myself. And if I fuck it up, it's no big deal. If I don't learn how this stuff works, how the hell am I supposed to play the rest of the game? So I actually muted the audio of the game and in my headphones just so I could sit there. I was like, we're going to sit here for like 5 minutes. We're going to learn the menus. And I did. So I upgraded my shotgun a bit. I upgraded. That's how I got the spin move on the axe and stuff like that. And after that, I was like, did they shut up now? So then I unmuted all the audio. Like, yes, they're all quiet. Thank God. Now we can play the game. And for the rest of the stream, it was fine. You know, it was just that one really obnoxious part. But again, it seems like whoever the audio director was for the game is a piss poor audio director. They really don't understand what makes a game fun or when to have those moments of humor or whatever you want to do. I mean, honestly, it's kind of disturbing. There's a creature, a robot creature trying to kill you and it's talking dirty. You're like, ugh. It makes you feel like maybe that's what they were going for, like horror, right? They were going for a horror moment, to which I'm actually okay for that to be. It's a horror moment. It'll scare me for a bit. You know, but at the same time, then to have that be droning over a critical moment where I'm learning a gameplay element, right? So, I didn't check. I have no clue, but you would think that's probably what all the morons on the internet were talking about yesterday when it comes to, oh, Phil couldn't take the stupid sexual fridge. And you know what was funny? Because after that part, when I unmuted and everything, someone made a comment in the chat and they were like, so you ruined the game because you did this, that. And I was basically like, well, here's what you can do. If you want to live that moment for yourself, you could get Atomic Heart. You could replay that moment on loop on your own console. And then you can, like, lick her icebox and you can shove her head into the fucking, the dairy section of the fridge. Whatever you want to do, if that's your kink or whatever, go for it. I mean, that's fine with you. Go for it. But for me, I'm trying to play a fucking game and learn it. So I don't want to dick around with this nonsense. I just want to fucking concentrate. And I couldn't do it. So, you know. There you go. Anyway. Trey did a super chat this morning. What is too much of adultness in games to you? You're flustered in by the fridge. In the South Park game, you laughed at the sight of testicles. I was not flustered by the fridge. I thought at first, okay, it's kind of stupid. You know what reminded me of it first? High on Life. All right? What annoyed me was that the fucking game wouldn't let up on it when you're trying to learn a critical part of the game. Imagine if you're playing High on Life and the game is teaching you, here's how to shoot and dodge. But as it's doing it, literally the game has tutorials on the screen of what to do. But as you're trying to do it, all the game will talk about is fucking fart jokes and sex jokes. It won't shut up. And it just continues and continues for like 2 minutes. Like, shut up. Shut the fuck up. I need to have my brain wrapped around this game I'm learning. I can't have this now. That's what I mean. The audio director is a moron. You don't have that shit playing when someone's trying to learn a critical menu that you'll have to use for the rest of the game. You see? There's a difference. During the South Park thing, that happened way into the game. It wasn't some tutorial part of the game. It was a silly boss fight. It was meant to be funny. Didn't matter if you could, you know, even keep your composure during the boss fight. It wasn't a big deal. Here, you're learning a critical game component, and the game has to be stupid. Just shut the fuck up and let me learn the game. I didn't even care what the game was saying at that point. It could have literally been Jim Carrey in my ear. Hey, you want to hear the most annoying song in the world? Like, oh! No, I just want to learn the game. Shut up. Well, now someone tipped $1 says, oh no, that's not a facetious tip earlier. I'm asexual. And that kind of stuff bothers me. So of course, what that means is now my trolls must be saying I'm asexual. There you go. Oh, here we go. Phil is married, but not really because he's asexual. And he won't have kids because he's asexual. This is going to be the next meme. Here we go. Asexual Phil. ASP, asexual Phil. Here we go. Let's start it. Let's just start it now. Let's get the meme going now. Asexual Phil. Perfect. Sounds good. Sounds really good. Let's keep that going. Asexual Phil. You know, every other YouTuber who's been around as long as me has had a sex scandal but me. It's because I'm asexual Phil. That's why, of course. There you go. ASP. I received a $6 tip. I'm not a troll. Stop mischaracterizing me. It stresses me out. I like to remain anonymous. Okay. I haven't said your name. I said anonymous the whole time, actually. So, a $6 anonymous tip from this person. Okay. You're not a troll. You're not being facetious. There's no meme that I'm asexual. All right, I take it back. We're going to delete the meme. There's no meme that it's an asexual side, Phil. There you go. We're taking it away. I mean, geez, if I really was asexual, I must have really hated all those years where I was constantly making sex jokes, you know, to appease a teen audience, you know, 10, 15 years ago. I must have been like the Mark Summers of content creation. Are you aware of the story of Mark Summers? Does anyone know who that is? Mark Summers was a game show host for Nickelodeon in the 1980s and 90s. And he would literally host Double Dare, a show where families would get together to do trivia. And if they couldn't answer the questions, they would take a physical challenge, which would commonly get them completely covered in shit. You know, goo, peanut butter, green slime, or whatever. It was one of the messiest shows it was. And Mark Summers would constantly be covered in crap. Come to find out, he's a lifetime obsessive compulsive disorder sufferer. In his real life, everything has to be neat and cleaned and aligned. And if he gets a speck of dirt on him, it drives him nuts. And his job was to be completely covered in shit all day. Can you imagine? That guy gets insane badass points that he actually was like suffering all day long for his job. And he was, by the way, one of the nicest guys and best game show hosts of that era. So like to this day, people still remember him so fondly from their childhood watching him on Nickelodeon. What a great guy he was. So holy shit, what a badass, right? So is that what you're saying? That I'm asexual, but somehow, you know, all those years of stupid, immature commentary must have tortured me, right? Long Wang the Dragon King. Long Wang. Long Dong Wong and Long Wang, the tag team of legends. They can't even be defeated. They actually team up to defeat the evil wizard. I see. Oh, come on. It's so bad. What are we watching? What the fuck is this? What does this have to do with the game? No, seriously, what is this? What does this have to do with the plot? The stupid king. Oh, I feel a stirring in my loins. It's either I am aroused by the dancing, or it is those three beef brisket tacos that I had for breakfast. Perhaps I should go to the bathroom just in case. Yes!
A wonderful display.
Dong Zhuo.
Tell me your name.
My name is Jailbait.
Diao Chan.
Oh my gosh. I'm 12 years old. What? No chat agents are available today to chat with you. You have to call us. What the hell is that? Why? Well, that's stupid. They're supposed to be there 24/7 and no chat agents are available. All right. So I have to call. Already it's a huge hassle. So I call and I put my information in. Of course, none of the options in the menu are like talking about, oh, you have a second installation appointment for no reason. You don't know why and you want to talk to someone about it. Of course, there's no menu option for that. So you're fucking around with the automated menu trying to figure out, put me somewhere to talk to somebody. I'm not kidding. I had to go wait on hold 25 minutes and the phone hung up on me. I was not pleased. Okay? To say the least. That really pissed me off. So I had to do it again. And then eventually I get to talk to a rep. It probably took me about 45 minutes to finally get a rep on the line. I talked to his, now this is a sales rep. I explain the situation. And the sales rep says, well, yes, I see in the system you have one appointment for your first date, which was yesterday, but you have another appointment for next week. I said, I never made that appointment. I don't even know what that appointment's for. I need to talk to someone about this and figure out what is going on. All right, well, we don't deal with that. We're going to have to forward you to the booking department and they'll talk to you about it. All right, fine, whatever. So they forward me over to this other department. You know, a woman picks up, incredibly heavy accent. So you know this is not in the United States. This is a call center somewhere, okay? When you get to a call center somewhere, you know that they have no ability to help you. I'm sorry, it's just a case. You get forwarded to a call center. Call centers mean they just sit there, they read a script. And if this, you go off the script, they can't help you. Okay? So I'm talking to some woman in a call center, and she says, okay, here's what happened. You have two accounts. So when you initially did that two-hour conversation with the sales rep to renew your contract, he put up the installation appointment for one of your accounts. But you need two installation appointments because you have two accounts. And I said, no, I don't. I'm going to have one appointment where one tech will come out here and do all of the work. I'm not going to do two appointments for you because you don't know how to run your company. I'm going to have one appointment. It's that simple. I'm not wasting time with you. We're going to have one appointment, and it's all going to happen. And this woman, her brain proceeded to melt through her ears, all over her shoulders, because she probably had never heard something like that before. She had no idea what to do, okay? She couldn't change the appointment. She had no... I said, well, can I talk to your supervisor? Can you forward me to another department? She had no idea what to do. She literally admitted to me on the phone, I have no clue. All I do is read a script. I don't know what to do at all. I said, can you help me in any way? No. Oh, you can't? No, there's nothing I can do. All I can do is reschedule appointments. So if you want to change the dates and times of these appointments, I can do that. But outside of that, I can't help you with only having one appointment. Like, there's no way to do that. The system doesn't allow for it. There's no supervisor she has that can interject or help. She has no one to go to. She just sits there and does this all day at a call center and has no power to do anything. And I'm like, oh, that's interesting. Okay, so what do we do now? And she's like, well, I don't know. I was like, well, she said, here's what I want to do. I want to send you back to sales. You want to send me back to the sales department, the department that I took 45 minutes to talk to and couldn't help me and directed me to you. Okay. So she tried and said, oh, I can't get sales on the line. I said, no kidding. It took me 45 minutes to get them on the line. What makes you think you're going to get them on the line? So literally she lied to me. She had no idea what she was doing. And she lied to me and said, someone will follow up with me. No one followed up with me. Okay. So then what I proceeded to do was I contacted the social media team for my company. And I explained the whole situation. I said, this is the stupidest thing ever. You guys don't know how to run your company. They agreed with me. What do I do with this stupid thing? Save. Where do I do a pole position to get this working? I don't remember. Stupid strip club. Mr. Versetti outfit. Is there a Mr. Versetti outfit I could put on in here? Oh, great. You have to do the lap dance to do this? Oh my god. What happens is money, you lose money. Well, while this is happening, let me blow my nose because my nose is killing me now because I sneezed. Hold on. Oh my god, look how stupid this is. Fucking dumb. Even this version is a terrible character model. Oh my god. Oh. This is very exciting. This is very exciting. What I mean is my nose blowing is very exciting. Clear now. No more sneezing. You gotta like some of these dance moves. What the fuck? Oh my god. The sad fact is, there were people, kids, who wanted this game for this, what you're looking at right now. Like, I want this game because it has this in it. Like, Okay, then. Castro Jenkins likes this part of the content. There you go. It's very exciting. Very exciting content. Leave? I thought you can't. Didn't people say you have to wait like $300? It's draining the money. See, it's draining my money. I think you have to wait for like $300 to be drained. And then you can leave and then it works. Oh my god. Tommy isn't even looking, of course. Who the fuck would look at this? This is embarrassing. This is seriously embarrassing right now. Are we good now or what? I don't know how this works. I need to know how this works so we can do it. Are we done or not? Can I stop doing this? I want to stop doing and fucking get this bit business. You can leave at 16,700. Okay. I will leave at 16,700. We're almost there. Who the fuck would pay this woman to dance like this? Oh my god. Okay. Okay. No, I've told you guys I've never been to a strip club in real life. I always thought it was a complete waste of money and time. It was stupid. Okay. All right. What the fuck is that? Did you see how bad that? It looked like a clam. It looked like a poorly rendered clam. Look at that. She walks like her pants are too tight.
You cock.
She can't move her legs.
Benedikta.
Ew. Wow, it's like holding a Cabbage Patch Kid.
Take care.
Does the lion take care?
Wow. When he chases. Look at the scale.
Or do you think me one of the latter?
No, my love.
Oh my god.
You are a lion. You're my lion.
I'm absolutely revolted. I'm afraid. Look at this disgusting frost, behavior.
Benedikta. But I will need someone to warm me when I come home.
Wow. You know, they said it was going to be like Game of Thrones. I didn't know they were actually going to copy the scenes. There you go.
The front lines are gone.
Uninstall the game immediately. Chaos will conceal. Oh! Uninstall! I'm not convinced she's a human yet. I think she's like a goblin in disguise. A goblin wearing a human suit. That's what I think.
The land has fallen. The eastern territories all but belong to the orcs.
Oh, great.
I'll have my men ready to depart.
Oh, look, it's gonna be Game of Thrones. Right now, here we go. They have to have these scenes. Game of fucking Thrones.
Tonight would engulf the mines ere long. Besides, you already have your orders.
Who is Barnabas? I don't even know who this is.
Yes, my liege.
Barnabas.
The dark swallows more of the realm with each passing day. The land starved of the ether that gives it life. And as the fringes fade, the people flock to the mother crystals, desperate for their blessing. The war we wage for possession of that blessing, it breaks us from within, hastening us to our own destruction.
And so you do what must be done.
I unite the dominants, that we may bring an end to the strife, and found a new order to see us unto tomorrow. The world must be restored, and I will see it so.
You might have already had Sidolphus not betrayed us.
Him again. Lust you still for his embrace?
But of course not.
So Barnabas is the king.
My liege. I serve you, and you alone.
So stupid. 1,000,000%. They're trying to be like edgy
well
Game
the
of Thrones.
First entered these halls. Your pale hand pressed into his, as if it would never let go.
That was a long time ago. Yours is the only hand I need. Now and always.
Soon, my dear. Soon all will know whose hand it is that keeps them from falling into the darkness.
Hold me.
Do we really need to see his whole body too?
Let me go.
Seriously. It's so lame. And by the way, what was the point of that scene? What purpose did that scene actually serve in the entirety of the game? Nothing. It's pretty sad, actually, the direction that they took for this.
Report, m'lady. Your orders.
And I will say this one final thing. Now, this is my pet peeve. You guys can completely disagree on this point, and that is perfectly fine, but I want to get this off my chest, all right? When they announced that this would be the first mature-rated Final Fantasy game, a lot of people said, well, I don't understand why. Well, now we know why. Right in the first few hours, there's excessive gore and or brutal murders right in front of you, and there's sexual content, sexual scenes, right? We haven't had stuff like that in Final Fantasy before. So, again, I get it. They're going for the Game of Thrones idea. But you have to understand that in a game like a fantasy game, less can be more. So I'll give you a perfect example. There's a female character who's basically supposed to be a manipulator. She sleeps with guys, she gets them to do what she wants, and because of that, a lot of, like, it's actually the plot is like one of the characters in your party interacts with her and says, you didn't used to be like that. You used to be a good person. I trained you to use your powers, but now you're using everything in your ability for bad. Basically, you're manipulating everyone around you. What happened to you? What changed you to be such a horrible person? It's part of the plot. I get it. But here's the difference. I could have just been told that she's like that. I didn't have to see it. There's literally like a 3+ minute cutscene of her in bed with the king. And literally nothing happens during the cutscene. Nothing. It doesn't add anything. It's like they wanted to have the Game of Thrones sex scene in the game. So they had to have it. You understand? Like, here it is. But what is this adding to the game? Literally nothing. You could have just said it was happening. Or it could have been alluded to, or there could have been a side conversation about it instead of actually having the whole scene. It's almost like they're trying to cater to an audience that wants the adult content, right? Ooh, I want to see the side boob in the scene. I want to see, instead of just saying, okay, the Duke was injured or murdered, they have to show brutal blood exploding and guts shooting out, and it's like, you know, listen, there's an audience for that. There is. But I don't know if it's the Final Fantasy audience. You know what I'm saying? Like, it feels like they're definitely trying to cater to people who like the over-the-top excess of adult content. Now, the thing that's funny about it is there's no nudity in this game. There's not. So the entire scene in the bedroom is fucking stupid. Because all it shows is, oh, an arm is blocking the guy's balls and crotch. And, oh, look, the camera angle just happens to only shoot from here up and you can't see anything below. What the hell is the point? Seriously, it's like, It's bad in that regard. It really is. It's stupid. Like, why is this in the game? They're trying too hard to be edgy. You know what I'm saying? Now, that's my pet peeve. You can disagree, and that's fine. Maybe it doesn't bother you at all. For me, I've played all the Final Fantasies, and at this point, it's like, dude, why is this in the game? It just doesn't need it. It doesn't add anything to have this shit in it. Besides, we're trying to be different and edgy, guys. Come on, look, we really did it this time. We went all the way. No, you didn't. When there's a fucking bedpost blocking the guy's testicles so I don't see them, you didn't go all the way. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's pretty stupid. I received a $3 tip from Shit Swirls. I remember you were playing God of War. There were sex scenes, and since you've gotten married, things have changed. Whenever there's a sex scene or nudity, you cringe, then you go on a rant about it. Okay, the difference here is that I'm older. It has nothing to do with being married. Has to be with, I'm older and I don't look for that crap in video games anymore. Do you understand? Like, when you're younger and you're more immature, you get more pleasure out of that stuff, right? Oh, it's risque. It's adult. Oh, it feels so good. I don't look for that stuff in a video game. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you have sexuality in your life, in a way that you enjoy, in a way that you're very satisfied with, you don't then have to go search for sexuality in video games. I don't play video games for sexual content. I play them for gameplay that's enjoyable. I play it for good stories. I mean, it's okay to have romance in a video game. That's perfectly fine. But for example, the scene that I referenced yesterday in Final Fantasy 16 was literally superfluous to anything. It wasn't needed. It didn't prove a point. It literally could have been explained in a sentence. But they had to show the scene to appeal to a certain audience. Do you understand? That risque audience looking for the adult content ate it up and gobbled it up. Oh, I love it. The adult Game of Thrones adult content. You see? When I was younger, what was I doing on YouTube? I was trying to cater to a young, immature audience. I constantly was making sex jokes, racial jokes, gender jokes. I was doing these jokes all over the place to constantly fill dead air and entertain an audience that otherwise was pretty immature, and they ate it up. They loved that content. That's who I was appealing to. Today, I'm 41 years old. I'm not looking to appeal to a bunch of teenagers. If you look at my actual analytics on YouTube, I have very few young viewers. My viewers are usually in their 20s to 30s, and some in their 40s, like me. That's my age range that I'm appealing to. I'm not appealing to young teenagers. Those people are going out and watching the memesters. They're watching the fucking popular streamers, the drama queens. They're watching bullshit content. That's what appeals to them, the immature shit. That's the kind of shit I used to put out 10, 15 years ago, and I don't anymore. You see, I've changed. I feel for the better, because I've grown and matured as a person and a content creator. That's nothing to do with being married. It has to be just getting older and wanting to put out something that you feel is more meaningful to yourself. Do you want to know the truth? It was actually cringeworthy when I had to do that content constantly. It was. It was actually like taxing. It was boring. I gotta play another game and I gotta constantly keep making sexual comments, right? And here's the other funny part about it too. Back then, everyone criticized me for it. I'd say probably around 2012, 2013, when the This Is How You Don't Play movement started. One of the big things everyone made fun of me for was that content. Oh, he's always wants to talk about sex. He always wants to see the sex scene. He always has to over-sexualize everything, right? So everyone told me I was wrong for doing it. So over the years, I change, I mature. I phase out that kind of talk and that kind of any kind of seeking that in video games, and I criticize when it's in it because I feel it's superfluous. Oh, so you change for the worse. Wait, what? This is what you told me to do because you said that I was immature and that the content wasn't good enough, so you even made fun of me and this is how you don't play and everything, so I changed directly based on your criticism. I improved. Now I change for the worse. So what the fuck are you talking about? You can't have it both ways, right? That's the truth, is that the internet wasn't in it to basically say to me, all right, that they weren't in it to say that your content is immature, improved. They were just saying, we don't like you and your content no matter what you do. That's really what it was. That's the difference between constructive criticism and toxic criticism. Please improve for the better. We just don't, it's never going to be good enough. That's two different things, you understand? And that's what I've gone through, is basically being told no matter what I do and how I improve, it's never good enough. So guess what? I'm going to put out content that I like. All right? So yeah, if I see that shit in a game and I think it's stupid and it's unnecessary, I'm going to call it out. There was no reason to have that scene in Final Fantasy 16. It literally added nothing. And it was laughably cringeworthy because, again, here they go with their editing. Oh, look, the arm is blocking the nipple. The fucking bedpost is blocking the dick. Like, what is this stupid shit? Like, I feel like I'm fucking watching something from 20 years ago that's like a fucking National Lampoon or fucking Naked Gun movie or something. You know what I mean? Like, what am I watching? It's so dumb. Initially, I was torn because the audience was torn. Half the audience was like, wow, looks like Phil will absolutely like this and we'd like to see him play it. And then there was another half of my audience who were like, meh, I don't like turn-based RPGs. Oh, it's anime. Ugh, anime. And you get the idiots who come in, oh, look at boobs, look, there's boobs, boobs. Like, these idiots have never seen women before in any kind of Japanese culture, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, the Japanese have a thing about women and boobs. They do. For some reason, every anime, almost every girl has to have, like, giant boobs, and they're always in your face, and the women are, like, half-dressed, all right? In One Piece, some of the guys are half-dressed, too. Like, there's a guy there who's wearing underwear. Like, he's wearing a Speedo, okay? But this is how they've always been. This is typical of Japanese culture. This is to be expected, all right? You can't avoid it if you do things that are Japanese-centric, anime. This is always part of it, all right? Guess what? It's always been like that. I don't think it's going to change anytime soon. It's time to grow up a little bit. Sitting on someone's stream who's playing a One Piece RPG. Oh, boobies, boobies. It's like, what are you, 4 years old? Like, the fuck is your problem? Yeah, we get it. We're not blind. Do you have to fucking talk about it every 2 seconds? No one gives a fuck besides you. You're the mouth-drooling idiot. So here's what you do. You say, before you type, here's what I want you to do. Put your hands in your pockets like this and just shut up. Because no one cares about you spamming my chat with dumb shit like that. Like, you sound like a fucking idiot. Okay, anyway. So, I liked it. I was like, wow, this would be a good playthrough. It's JRPG style. I love JRPGs. It's an anime slash manga that I enjoyed previously in my life. Haven't watched it or read it in a long time. But I was like, this would probably be something really good. I bet people would like this playthrough. But it really seemed live. The audience was torn. It was like a 50-50 split on if I should play this game or not. I gotta say, I don't know how you do it with One Piece Odyssey. Here we go again. Here you go. What is it with all these Japanese artists always creating characters with huge over-exaggerated boobs? I mean, it's just a thing. It's just a thing with them. Seriously, take a look at anime. For some reason, it's like normalized in their culture. They don't even... Here's the weird thing about this, too. Did you know the Callisto Protocol was banned in Japan because the Japanese deemed that the death animations in the game were too gory to be released in that country? I just want you to think about this. The death animations in Callisto Protocol were deemed too gory, right? So they couldn't be in the game, they couldn't sell the game. Yet, literally, all the sexual stuff is 1,000,000% allowed in their culture. No problem. They don't give a crap about that at all, right? It's like, geez. Anyway, it's confusing for sure. It's a weird double standard for sure. But yeah, I don't know. And again, I'm not going to let it distract me or bother me. I don't care. It's a freaking game with anime characters in it. Great. Big deal. Is it stupid that the women are like that? Yeah. It's also stupid that there's a dude wearing a Speedo too. You know, there's a lot of dumb shit in it. But you get to a point where you realize it's so normalized in that culture that it's not a big deal anymore. And I'll tell you right now, idiots that come by and they're going to try to talk about it constantly and everything, they're just going to be shown the door. Because that's not what it's about, obviously. We're not stupid. I played Final Fantasy VII. No one, you know, you stand there and talk about it all day, you get banned too. You're stupid. You know, I'm not going to be distracted by stupid idiots in the chat. That's not what we're here for. This is not the Dark Side Phil of 2010 or 2009 constantly commenting on it and doing stupid shit. You know, I've changed a lot in the last 5-6 years. As you know, we're doing a serious playthrough of the game. If you have an issue with that, go watch someone else out there who's going to literally comment on it every 5 seconds. That's not what you're getting here on DSP Gaming. In the West, gore and blood is glorified. Meanwhile, anything sexual in nature is seen as childish and pathetic. But in the East, gore and blood is deemed too intense, but things sexual in nature and media is normalized. It's like night and day. It's honestly baffling when people in the chat and you say sexual themes in games is stupid for people with no socialized or lore lives because it's a gross generalization. Again, I'm not saying, okay, again, you're generalizing what I'm saying. All right, here's the way I see it, okay? It's like everything in life, it's all about moderation, correct? And there's a certain level of judgment you got to use when you determine if something's being moderate or it's being way over the top. All right? I'm playing High on Life. And there's a running joke in High on Life that the character who plays your sister is getting into a romantic relationship with an alien. At first, you could think, oh, that's kind of funny, awkward comedy. It almost sounds like a sitcom, right? It could be kind of awkward, funny, maybe some Judd Apatow-style comedy or whatever, right? But then there's a whole scene where it's the two of them arguing about having sex and they're shooting goo on each other. I'm like, wait. You've gone too far. That's stupid. You know, you get to the ultra extremes and that's when you're like, okay, it was funny the first time I heard it. As a running joke, it works. It doesn't work when we have a fucking 5-minute scene having to hear these two argue about having sexual intercourse. It's disgusting, basically. Like, come on. You see? So that's what I mean. It's about moderation. I'm okay with gore. I'm okay with sexual themes as long as it's moderate. When you start pushing it as the selling point of your game, that's when you're kind of getting ridiculous, right? There's certain games out there that people are... That's what they think of when they think about the game. I mean, Catherine, right? That's a game where the whole plot is about a guy who's in a love triangle between multiple women, but then somehow there's fucking puzzles where he's a sheep or something. Like, it's like the gameplay doesn't even make sense. Obviously, you're in a stupid love triangle storyline. It's supposed to be sexual themes for adults, right? So it makes sense if that's what you're looking for, but that's what I mean, like, where's the game? And that's why I criticize that game. But anyway, you see the point I'm making. It's about clarification. It's about moderation. It's about not going over the top in any one direction. It's okay to have these things as an element of a piece of entertainment, as long as that's not the sole source. If it's going to be the sole source, now you're pushing towards, you know, 18 plus level content. And that's for anything, for gore, sex, whatever it is. You're pushing towards the extreme. And if that's the case, fine, but that's not kind of an all audiences style content that I do. I'm not going to be playing adults only rated games here on DSP Gaming for any reason. Doesn't matter if it's gore, sex, whatever. That's not what I do, you know? So I have to make sure that what I'm doing is moderate as well. You understand? But the point I'm making is, if I'm going to be playing a game and I'm enjoying it, right? And you can see I'm enjoying it from a moderate perspective. I'm not going crazy in one direction or another. To then start doing, who's your waifu? Who's your favorite? Do you have a crush on any of these girls? What do you think about the big boobs? It's like, dude, you sound like a fucking idiot. You are an idiot for saying this dumb shit on a stream that obviously is not wanting to discuss that, is not thinking about that stuff. Again, there's tons of content creators out there who probably are of that mindset, will play these games in that mindset. And if that's what you want, go over there to that style of audience. That's not me. I'm making content for people in their 20s and 30s and sometimes 40s. I'm not making content for a dunce teenager who's going to sit there thinking about what, you know, who they want to beat off to later. It's fucking gross. All right? It's not DSP Gaming. You mean like Rich? I wouldn't even know because I don't know what kind of content Rich puts out. Outside of the memes that I hear. I've never watched any of Rich's content, so I'm not going to say that. That would be kind of unfair. I don't know if he does that or not. I don't know. But you understand what I'm saying, right? Okay. I got a $2 tip. A lot of the folks will go... A lot of the people... Yeah, here you go. This guy has it right. This guy is 100% correct. I completely agree with this anonymous tipper. He's a lot of the folks that say dumb shit about boobs and stuff in your playthrough, like when I was playing One Piece the other night. They're the same people who do derail your content at any point and say things like, oh, Phil is married. And, you know, they've been making this joke for years and it stopped being funny years ago. Ignore that mess. Just enjoy the game. Thanks for playing a JRPG. I'll be sure to support it if you play. There you go. By the way, don't ever think that my game selection, my personal selection of a game that I want to play would be affected by those idiots. Never. The memes and everything. If I want to play a game and enjoy it, I'm going to fucking play it and enjoy it. And I'm not going to let those dunces ruin it for anyone. For me, for my viewing audience, no. Absolutely not. These immature people want to come in here and act immature. They're just not going to be here anymore. It doesn't bother me. Let them go to their restreams. Let them go to their circle jerking communities. Let them go to It's a Gundam and all these fucking idiots. And let them do the jokes there. They're not going to be doing them on DSP Gaming. You don't have to worry about that. Okay? Okay, so here's the thing, because again, some people take things incorrectly from how I said it. So yesterday, I don't want to really spoil my react to the Pro Jared documentary, because if I'm going to talk a little bit about it, because this person's addressing it in a tip, so this is going to spoil a little bit for those who didn't see it. But basically, there's a segment where I guess I'll say minor spoiler alert. If you don't want to know this, plug your ears. But one of the big issues that happens in Pro Jared's documentary and his life is that his wife accuses him of infidelity. But then he reveals that's not true because we were polyamorous, meaning, you know, we were basically married, but we were allowed to sleep around. Okay? To which I said, that is bullshit. I said, you know, in my opinion, this is my opinion. Other people can disagree, but my opinion is this. If you get married to someone, that is a concrete, distinct commitment. You're actively, as a mature adult, with full knowledge of what you're getting into, you're signing a legal document that says, I want to be with this person and this person exclusively for the rest of my life. Now, there's ways to get out of it later on, but that's not supposed to be what you're thinking. You're thinking, this is it. This is a lifetime commitment. If you're in that lifetime commitment with someone, you're supposed to be in a situation where that's all you want. You understand that? That's all you want. It shouldn't be, oh, so I have my marriage, but by the way, I also like to lust over other women or other men. Oh, I also want to have other things on the side. Oh, by the way, I can have waifus and I can watch anime that's perverted. Oh, by the way, I can do this. Like, wait. Then why did you get married? The whole point of the marriage is to say, I'm past that point. I'm no longer a player of the field. I want to be only with this one person forever. That is my romance now. That is it. That's what the step means. It's that you're committing to that situation for the rest of your life. If you're not ready for that, or if you're not sure that's what you want to do, then just don't get married. But what we're finding in modern society is that so many people are just told, you have to get married, you have to get married, you have to get married, you have to get married. Okay, fine, I'll fucking get married. So they're with someone, they're having, you know, they like them, let's get married. And then what happens? Within a couple of years, oh shit, I made a horrible mistake. So now, you know, you're playing video games, lusting over the fucking girls in the games and shit. Watching anime and watching movies, lusting over celebrities. That, oh, we want a polyamorous relationship. We're going to sleep around. We'll start cheating on each other. No, that's not what marriage is supposed to be, in my opinion. You can completely and utterly disagree, and that's okay, because that's your ability. That's the cool thing about humans. We all have the ability to have different opinions, but that's my take on it. And so when I'm watching the Pro-Jared documentary, and he said, oh, we decided to be polyamorous. No, you didn't. What you decided is that your marriage is broken. And rather than separate, because you thought it was going to be too difficult, right, to separate, you decided to fake it and just sleep around, which is not the correct answer. It's just going to lead to more problems. You see? And indeed it did. If you watch the rest of the documentary, as you can see, as my react continues to unveil this week, you'll see how much worse and worse it got because they did this. Okay? So this person tipped $1.50 and said, I don't like your criticism of waifus and people like who like that stuff, because what about people who've never had real partners? They're too busy having and enjoying waifus. It's less stressful. That's not what I'm criticizing. Now, by the way, I do wish that more people would be able to find meaningful relationships and have those relationships, because those are the best. That, you know, the relationship I have with my wife right now is the best relationship I've ever had in my life. I'm happier today, right now, than I've ever been before in my life. 1,000,000%, okay? So, I wish everyone had what I have. I do. I feel like so many people are looking for what I have and don't have it. And I feel bad, because I think more people deserve that level of happiness, and they don't have it. They don't even understand it. A lot of people don't think it exists. There's people out there that say love doesn't exist. It's bullshit. No, you just haven't had it. So you don't get it. And when you have it, you know it. And then you know how much better your life is. And that's sad that people will just sit there and say it doesn't exist because they've never experienced it before. That's very, very sad in my opinion. But listen, there's a whole culture over in Japan of people who are such hard workers, all right, that they don't have time for a private relationship. They don't have time to get into a romantic, monogamous relationship with someone. So to them, the whole go to the cafe, the hostess club, or the host club, and do that and have the virtual relationship that's not real and pay them for that. That's how they get their meaningful social interactions. The waifu culture. Oh, this virtual girl or guy, because isn't husbando and waifu, right? Those are my virtual companions or whatever, right? Listen, there's a whole culture around that. I'm not going to sit here to you and say, oh, I condemn it. Oh, it's awful. No, but what I'm going to tell you is I don't understand it, because from my perspective, it doesn't make sense. You know? I was single for a very long time in my life. I was. And yeah, when I was single, well, I was miserable for a lot of that time. But I also knew that having a real meaningful relationship was more important than a virtual one. I never paid for a virtual nonsense. Like, that doesn't make sense to me. But again, that's my head. That's everyone's different. That's the thing. Everyone has a right to an opinion. And for those who sit there and say that my opinion isn't valid, well, what makes your opinion more valid than mine? You can agree with me and you can disagree with me, and that's fine. That's discourse. That's the cool thing about a show like this. That's the cool thing about us having interactions like this, is that we can have these different perspectives, and that's fine. I respect your opinion. I respect your right. If you like that culture, right? If you want to have your waifus, you want to have those virtual relationships, that's okay. Go for it. I'm not going to sit here and tell you otherwise, because I don't think I'm any better than you. I'm happy with my life. I'm telling you how happy I am with my situation, you see? And I want you to understand why I think this would be a better situation for you. But if you don't get that and you don't agree, that's okay too. But then also, you got to respect my opinion too. You have to. You have to respect my opinion because mine is as valid as yours. All right? So thank you for the tip. I hope that clears it up. No, when I was criticizing yesterday marriage and all of that, that's not what I was saying. And especially if you're not married and you're into that stuff, then more power to you, I guess, right? That's a little different. The situation we were talking about was a committed married couple for several years, then decide they're going to be polyamorous. Like, what? No, that will not work. That will never work. So, Komi-san, this is the same person who did the dollar tip earlier. You bring up Japanese if it's the norm to not have a relationship and have a ton of waifus. Major parts of Japan are extremely conservative. It's wrong how you generalize it. Stop this now or I will throw a Burger King Whopper at you. If that's the case, I may continue because I love the Burger King Whopper. I would actually enjoy a Burger King Whopper being thrown at me. I might open my mouth and try to catch it. So I'm going to continue. I mean, no, you have to understand, I know what you're saying. What we're talking about is people in the major cities, right? That's where the life, the city life, is so busy with work and just, you know, take a look at how we're watching these documentaries and it's like, look at some people in certain Asian countries. Like, what was it? Was it Korea that we were looking? No, it was Hong Kong. They're living in coffin apartments. Coffin apartments. It's the size of a closet. That's where they live. They can't even stand up. They're just laying back like this, and they're surrounded by the walls and the door. That's their life, right? And I understand it's a generalization, but we're talking about things that affect us and the things that I do. How many games have we played that, oh, the waifu in the game, the waifu. Right, we just play in One Piece. Here's a perfect example: One Piece, the anime, and this game that I just played. Has there ever been, ever, nudity or strong sexual content in One Piece? Right, I don't think so. Correct, it's not considered an adult-rated anime or manga. Correct, it's not supposed to be. Then why am I playing One Piece Odyssey? And one of the main characters is in nothing but a bikini. The other one has insanely large breasts hanging out of a shirt. One of the characters at the end of the game is literally in nothing but loincloths. What the hell is that? Now, there's a time and a place for stuff. But it's out of place to the point where it seems to be an ingrained part of their culture to have the women half naked and everything. Why? I don't get it. You know, I get confused. There's time for that. If you want to have that kind of stuff for adult rated content, it's not adult rated. It's supposed to be like generalized content. They're just very lax when it comes to things like that. I mean, I was actually telling my wife about this. When I was a kid, one of the first Japanese TV shows I ever saw was Dragon Ball, original Dragon Ball. It was on American TV, and Goku, the kid, he's a child, was naked. His penis was out. He's a child, a naked child in an animated cartoon. What they had to do for American TV, they censored it and they drew a maple leaf over his junk. So he'd be walking on the screen with a weird maple leaf floating around in front of his junk to censor it for American television. And I was like, this is a child. What did it add to the show to have that in it? Nothing at all. But what it is, it's a difference in culture. In Japan, they don't find that weird or offensive. They think it's funny, I guess, to see child nudity. They think it's like a funny thing. Over here, we're weirded out. We're like, that's fucking weird. We don't want to see kids naked. Like, what the hell is that? Right? That's right. Madara's God says, and in the scene, he questions why Bulma does not have a penis. You're absolutely right. I forgot about that part. He says, why don't you have one? And she's like, huh? He starts touching her down in her crotch. He's like, where's your penis? He actually says this. That's part of the story. But, I mean, see what I'm saying? Like, it's weird. In their culture, this is all okay. And here, it's very different. Cultures are different. And it's okay to have different cultures. But it's also okay to talk about those cultures from your own cultural perspective, as long as you understand that. I'm not standing on a soapbox saying, anyone who likes it is wrong. All of you are horrible, you know, sexual deviants. I'm not saying that. I'm just giving you my take. I'm 40 years old, about to be 41. I'm happily married. I don't need that shit in my life. I have no desire to have any of that in my life. I don't need it. Maybe you do. And if that's okay, good for you. Enjoy. But don't piss on my parade. Don't say that I don't have the right
to have my own opinions and my own takes on this stuff. Because I do. As much as you have the right to defend it and say you like that stuff, I have the right to say I don't get it and I don't like that stuff. I don't want it. There you go. You have to see both sides. You can't just say, oh, my way or the highway. That's a very immature way to think about it. Life is not just black and white. Madara's God says, I'm okay with a little bit. Sometimes it's just too much. Like this one anime I watch, a girl has a bullet fly through her breasts. That's a little bit much for me. What? Like between? And it misses? Returnal, it is up to the individual to determine what they watch or not. He's saying, do you think married people should watch pornography? That's up to them. Everyone's going to have a different answer. Personally, no. I don't have no desire to watch pornography. I don't need to. All right? I'm in a romantic relationship with my wife, and if I want romance or anything sexual, I have a person to share that experience with. I don't need to open my internet to start looking for it online. Okay? But for some people, that's okay, I guess. I don't know. Again, I'm not here. I don't know why people come to me with these questions. Like, I'm going to give you some kind of authoritarian, answer. Do what you want. Why do I care? I actually feel like if more people had that attitude in life, things would be a lot more. If everyone was just more easygoing, right? Do the hell what you want. Why would I care? Just leave me out of it if I'm not interested, right? There you go. Actually, what an attitude. Do what you want. Why would I care? Just leave me out of it if I'm not interested. Actually, that could solve the world's problems. No? Really? Seriously? Because I think that's the problem. If you're not interested in something, but then you somehow have to be involved in it. No, I don't. If I'm not interested in it, I don't have to be involved in it. Just leave me out. Let me have my own life over here, and I'll let you have your life over here. If we ever cross paths for various productive reasons, great. But we don't all have to be in each other's shit constantly. Stay out of my shit, I'll stay out of your shit. How about that? I think that's a great philosophy. There you go. Check in. Okay. We then wait in the lobby for about another 10 to 15 minutes. So apparently they weren't ready regardless. And then a tech comes out. And the tech comes out and says, oh, you were early. I swear to God, this is what the tech says. She goes, oh, you were early. Well, the vet is late. Still on lunch. Stutters her words, like cuts herself off and changes what she was saying mid-sentence. Still at lunch. So obviously, the tech inadvertently admitted to us that the vet was late for work. Okay? So we can't get you in yet. You have to wait in the lobby, and once the vet is back from lunch, we'll let you in. But our appointment is at this time, and the vet's not here? Okay, so what is going on? Now, in the meantime, other people are coming in with their pets. There was someone who came in with two chihuahuas. They were let in within 5 minutes into an exam room, and you could hear the doctor over there examining and dealing with the chihuahuas, having a great time in the room. Another person comes in with a cat and a carrier. They're allowed right into an exam room. It's only us that are stuck in this lobby waiting with Jasper in his carrier. Now, if you add up the time, it's been over a half an hour he's sitting here in his carrier in the lobby, and we're not even allowed in yet. So finally, the tech is there, and I'm like, well, how long are we going to wait? What is going on? So the tech says, all right, we're going to take him in. The tech takes Jasper in, but not us. What? So now Jasper's in there by himself without us in the room, and we're not allowed to come in. Why not? The people with the chihuahuas are in the room. The woman with the other cat just went into the room. Why can't we go in? No, you stay in the lobby. Okay? All right. So they take Jasper in. 5 minutes. I'm not kidding. I timed it. 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, they take Jasper back out and hand it back to us in the carrier. And I'm like, did you do anything? Did you examine? Don't worry, the vet will be right with you. We wait another 20 minutes. So now Jasper has been in his carrier over an hour, and it's not even clear if they examined him or not. We don't know what happened yet, okay? So now we've been there an hour. Finally, a woman who they say, oh, I'm the vet. You should have seen this woman. All right, she comes out. First of all, everyone else that's working there has their like nurse slash tech garb on, so you can tell they work there. It says the name of the vet. This woman comes out in gray sweat clothes. It looks like she literally just came in off the street, maybe from jogging. I'm not sure. Her hair, you can literally tell she was late for work because her hair is dripping wet. You could tell what happened is she came in and just quickly brushed or combed her hair with water before she came out to the lobby. It literally had just been combed because it was wet as shit, right? So she comes out not dressed for work, with wet hair. Okay, so is that Jasper? Wait, what? You're the vet. Didn't you just examine him? Oh, is that Jasper? Okay, so here's what we found. Okay? So here's what the vet says. First of all, well, has he ever had blood work? And I'm like, you work here. He's been here for 3 years. You don't know if he's had blood work yet. So I said, no, he hasn't had blood work. He's never had a reason to have blood work. He's never had a serious illness or whatever. So, you know, he never had that, you know. So he's here for his exam and his rabies vaccine, right? So they said, okay, well, you know, we think he should have blood work. Why? Well, you know, it's a routine thing for these cats. Every few years, they should have blood work. It's a way to check for diseases. It's a way to check for this or that. I'm like, all right, so let's talk. Let's be real here. Let's talk cost. What do I owe you now? And what am I going to owe you if we have blood work? Okay? So he goes, well, for the exam and the rabies vaccine today, it's $109. Okay? But if we do the blood work, it's $450. What? And I was like, $450? But there's nothing wrong with him. Why do I want you to do $350 blood test? Right? But this vet is actually like hard selling me on getting this blood test. Like, he's not sick. You know? And she keeps pushing it. She's like, no, really, I'm telling you, I'm recommending as the you should. I was like, we're not doing the blood test. All right? This is ridiculous. Like, we're not doing this blood test. He came here for one thing. This is absolutely ridiculous. So, by the way, at this point, we don't even know if he received his vaccine or anything. This vet told us nothing. So the vet says, all right, well, I'll be back. And goes into the back and disappears, I shit you not, for another 20 minutes. 20 minutes! And then comes back again. Well, never comes back. We never saw the vet again. If that even was the vet. I don't know. There was nothing on the thing, the person to say they were the vet. Okay? Finally, the vet tech comes out again. So now we've been here almost 90 minutes. Jasper's been in this carrier, and he's very upset. He hates being in the carrier. And he's been in here for 90 minutes. By the way, we weren't allowed into the room. If he even saw a room, I don't even fucking know. Right? I have no clue. And, what you want to talk about a night and day experience. Last year, they're nice, they're kind. Within 20 minutes, we're in an exam room. Jasper's out of the character. He's out of the carrier. He's playing. He's enjoying himself. He's having a good time, right? He gets his vaccine, which is quick. We're out of there within 40 minutes. We're 90 minutes into yesterday's visit, and we don't even know what's happened yet. I was ready to walk out. Kat was very upset. She's like, I want to get out of here. This is absolutely ridiculous. I said, if they don't come within 5 more minutes, we're leaving. And then they can figure out how to bill us. Because I've had enough of this. This is fucking ridiculous. How we're being treated, right? So, finally, the vet tech comes out again, not the vet, and says, all right, we're all set. I said, what do you mean you're all set? We're ready to go. What do you mean you're ready to go? Did he get his vaccine? Oh, yeah, well, we brought him back before. We examined him. We got him his vaccine. He's good to go. You didn't tell us. You never even... We've been sitting here an hour and a half. You never even told us that you did that, right? So I go up to the front, and I pay for the exam and the vaccine, and they give me that tag that says that he's been vaccinated or whatever, and they hand me a ton of paperwork. Now, I don't know what any of this paperwork is, okay? I wouldn't know until I have a chance to read it. And I said, we got Jasper home. We had a ton of shit to do. We had to go grocery shopping. We had to do a ton of stuff. So later that night, all right, I come home, and we're finally, it's time. Let's read the paperwork. It's like 8, 9 p.m. now, right? So I start reading the paperwork. And on the paperwork, all of a sudden, it says all this shit on the paperwork that this vet never told us about, all right? Number one, it explains the whole vaccination process. It says last year he got his first dose. this year's the booster. Now that he got the booster, he doesn't need a rabies vaccine for 3 more years. So we don't have to worry about getting him back to the vet for his vaccine next summer. It's taken care of. Cool. We got 3 years to wait till 2026. Did the vet tell us that? No. Never explained. Another thing, and this really got me, okay? There's something on there that we absolutely should have known. The vet didn't tell us. It says, Jasper is starting to show early signs of a little bit of dental plaque. Now, it's early. What you can do is you can do, like, dental treats. You buy cat dental treats and things, and it'll actually start cleaning their teeth nicely. And as long as you do it regularly, it should be not be a problem at all. He should be good, all right? But it even says on there, some cats, it doesn't actually help, you know, using the dental treats. And long-term, they might need to get tooth cleanings, all right? So keep an eye on it. The vet didn't fucking say that at all. Now, after the vet appointment, during our day out, we went to the pet store and we actually bought Jasper things. We could have bought him the dental treats, but we didn't know we needed to get them because the vet didn't fucking say anything. Okay? So literally, we went to the vet for an hour and a half. Jasper was seen for 5 minutes, and literally the vet told us none of the information that we should have known while we were there and expected us to just figure it out later by reading this giant stack of fucking paperwork that they gave us to go home with. Okay? So, after that, we are not going back to this vet. And it's a shame because we actually had a great experience with this vet last year. We thought the vet was great. Now that COVID was over and you're able to go into the exam rooms with your pet again, we had a great time. He had a great time. I have pictures on my phone of Jasper having a blast at the vet last year. I'm not even kidding. Let's see if I can find it. I'm gonna go all the way back here. Hold on. Almost. It's Christmas. Here it is. Here's Jasper at the vet last year when they let him into the exam room and he was chilling on the counter. He's having fun. He had a great time. You know, not in the carrier the whole time. That was August of 2022. This year, it's like a completely different fucking place. Like, you know, what happens to these places? How is it that in a year, they completely changed their entire process? Why did everyone else around us get to go into a room with their pet, but not us? Why were we rushed in and out for 5-minute exam, but kept there for 90 minutes? Why was the vet late? Because that's the truth. But the problem is, I think, here's what I really think happened. The vet is basically, we got the worst vet in the place, right? They were already late for work. So we had to wait extra just for the vet to show up. And then when they showed up, it was a rush job. Oh, he's just here for his yearly exam. All right, get him in quick. Let's do this fast. Do-do-do-do-do. Okay, we're done. On to the next. Well, they're still here. Oh, shit, I got to go out there and talk to them. Oh, man. Oh, and I got to do my hair. And runs out in the sweat clothes. Hey, everyone. So just so you know, by the way, let's upsell on a $300 blood test. And let's try to scam the fucking poor people out of $300 that we definitely don't need to spend, but they're being idiots about it. You know what I mean? Like, oh, I made like no money on this visit today, so let's try to upsell them to make profit, right? It's exactly what it was. A $300 fucking blood test, you know? Like, are you out of your mind? So, we're not going back. We're done, you know? And it's sad because, like I said, last year it was completely different. I felt like it was a great vet a year ago. And then somehow this all changed, you know, in the last year. And now it's a completely different business. Like, I would never go back there after that. That was such a horrible experience, right? So, yeah, so that's it. So anyway, that was our experience. And it sucked because, you know, this is something that we were hoping would be under an hour. All in all, with that taking so long and the driving, it was over 2 hours out of our day, and now we were way behind. So we didn't actually get to do everything that we were supposed to do or wanted to do yesterday. You know, we got maybe half the stuff that we wanted to do. We had a lot of things lined up, and we're like, well, we're too tired. We don't have time to do it. What are you going to do, right? So it is what it is. You know, it's pretty sad. It's pretty sad that that's how we were treated after having such a great experience last year. Out here, there's a lot of competition for pet health care. There's a ton of vets. There's a ton of these places. So why they think they're going to do well in an environment when you have direct competition literally right around the corner, I don't get. But, you know, we'll see. We'll see what happens moving forward. Hopefully, we find a better one, you know. The ex-Mata says, do you ever thought to ask them why the visit went like that? Yeah, it's called customer feedback, which you're supposed to give after your visit. Oh, we're going to give it to them. Don't get me wrong. There's no we're going to give them the feedback that they deserve, and they're going to understand why we're not ever going there ever again after being treated like that, you know? The point is, it doesn't matter why. The fact that it happened is bad enough. I don't care. Oh, it was an extenuating circumstance. Well, I don't want to be your extenuating circumstance. I want to go somewhere where I'm treated like everyone else. Not that we're the ones sitting in the waiting room for 90 minutes while everyone else got to go into a room. And we just sit here with our cat and our carrier for that time. And you don't do anything. And you want to upsell me on a $350 blood test. Like, get the fuck out of here. So, yeah, that's that. And, you know, they'll get our feedback. And it is what it is. It sucked. It sucks to even have to talk about it, but, you know, something to vent about, something to tell you, want to know about what happened on my day off, that's what happened on my day off, okay? All right, let's talk about today, let's talk about the schedule, okay? So, someone literally said the entitlement. Wow, you're a fucking idiot. You think that a consumer be asking to be treated like all the other consumers in the same business and getting the money, you're getting what they pay for, getting a good experience, especially when there's competition in the area, you think that's entitlement. No, you're an asshole. You're a complete idiot. Go fuck yourself. I mean, it's a pretty dumb statement, don't you think? That's like, you say you go into a restaurant, a table of four, you all order the same deal, three of you get your food at the same time, and it's all great quality, you have to wait an extra half hour to get your food, and when the food comes out, it's all fucked up, and then they want to charge you more for it than everybody else. But if you complain, that's entitlement. Wow. You people on the internet are real smart when you say shit like that, right? Oh, and by the way, one other thing I should say. You could get something called pet insurance. That also is pretty inexpensive. And for, you know, a little bit a month, basically what they do is they cost up to a certain level of medical cost, etc. And we have that for him. So, you know, a few bucks a month. If something goes horribly wrong and we have to end up paying thousands of dollars in medical bills, the insurance will cover up to a certain amount. We'll cover the whole thing, of course not. But as long as you can prove that it was some kind of a weird circumstance that happened, the pet insurance will usually cover it. And that way you don't have insane amounts of cost out of nowhere that you can't afford. And I'll be very honest here as well. My parents are pet lovers. They're cat lovers. They have multiple cats. And, you know, talking with them, when we got Jasper, they said, yeah, more than likely if anything went horribly wrong, they would be able to help out a little bit. You know, don't worry about, oh God, if something happens, now you can't afford it or something like that. They would be able to, you know, at least do a little bit to help out. So there you go. Looking for.
Bitch.
Whoa! Don't sneak on me, bitch. Jesus. I literally just met you. You've already called me a bitch.
Hey.
I'm sorry we surprised you, but you shouldn't talk to Kaede like.
Hey.
Hey, Crush Rot. You're staring at my tits. What the fuck? What? Help yourself. A guy you can only dream of landing a big boob hottie like me. What the fuck? It looks like she's vomiting. What the? Go on. Get yourself a good eyeful. No, I wasn't staring. My eyes just happened to look there. My eyes just happened to look there. My eyes just happened to grope there. What the fuck? I can identify pervs on sight, and you're definitely a fucking perv. That's why you wear that hat to hide your skeevy eyes. That's why you wear pants to hide your nasty crotch. What the fuck is going on? Everyone wears pants. Everyone knows only pervs wear hats. Okay, then. Stop it. Leave me alone. I can wear a hat if I want to. What the hell are you getting pissed off at me for? Tell the world you're sorry.
I am ready. My apology, please.
No, you're not getting one. You startled me into losing motivation. That loss will be felt across the whole world. What is going on already? This game is fucking weird. Your vulgar language is uncalled for. Who are you anyway? Seriously, you don't know who I am? I'm the Gorgita.
Looks and golden brain will go down in history. I'm the one, the only, the legendary ultimate inventor herself,
Mew Iruma. Okay. Ultimate inventor.
What were you looking for earlier? You sounded pretty desperate to find
it. What was that?
Are you a dumbass? In a situation like this, I gotta find some meds.
Huh?
Medicine? Are you hurt or feeling sick?
Fucking
no, idiot. I need strong meds because I want to trip my fucking balls off. Oh, my God. I just want to set my mind free and forget all this shitty situation.
Oh, jeez.
You can't use drugs to get high. You definitely shouldn't do that. What the hell? My genius can be constrained by the wisdom of the masses. Besides, this place probably doesn't even have the shit that I need to get loosey-goosey. Oh my God. Are we cool? Are you dumb being mad at me? They say there's a fine line between genius and insanity, but she's definitely beyond insane. What the hell? There's just some weirdo characters for sure. This is the weirdest one so far. You're too weak, Kibo. Let me remodel you and make you the strongest robot ever.
That being said,
first, I'll soup up your crotch plate by installing a nice thick one, just how I like it. Oh my God, the cringeworthy writing. Come on now. This is so stupid.
Who's the guy that you're with?
I don't know, some other android that's
why
helping you.
Why isn't he dressed in fucking... Why isn't he in like a studded fucking banana hammock? With like fucking a garter belt and a fucking dog collar. Why is it?
No, he should have a ball gag and a giant cod piece sticking out of his crotch. Look at you two. Out for a walk together, huh? Why don't you pick up some rubbers over at the warehouse? Better safe than sorry.
Huh?
We don't need those. You must be a real fucking skank to let dudes unload inside you. Oh my God, what? By day you're fingering the piano keys, at night the dudes are fingering you? This is just a disgusting pervert.
Oh,
shut the hell up, what kind of girl do you think I am? It was a joke, I was trying to lighten the mood a little. Let's ignore her, Kaede, we have to focus. That's fucking, she's gross, man. Like, she's outright just fucking nasty. Why is she saying that stuff? The difference between joking and going too far. That's fucking disgusting. Morning, Mew. Well, if it isn't flat-chested Kaede, what do you and your pathetic tits want? What the fuck? You make them by tomorrow morning?
Shut up!
Of course I can. If you tie me up and drip hot wax on me, I'd still finish it in time. With that bold declaration, Mew slammed the door in our faces. Did she reveal some of her kinks to us? Yeah. Oh my God. I can't do shit about that. Calm your tiny tits and shut up.
Oh,
shut up. My chest is bigger than your... Oh my God. Alright, I'm not saying this.
What did I do?
I'm not saying this... Stupid, like I said, some of the writing is so dumb.
You're getting awfully worked up. Look at you. You're sweating.
This is it.
I'm always wet. I'm just feeling extra sensitive. Like these big boobs of mine.
Oh my God. Fucking pervert. So
good job, Kaede. Guess I shouldn't have judged you by your lackluster rack. What Gilgamesh?
No comment on the stupid dialogue. Wait a minute. You don't need to bow, just listen to what I gotta say. What a stupid bitch. I seriously hate her character. Just as I predicted, detectives get excited for casino games like boys get excited for holes. Oh my God, she's such a fucking pervert. I hate her. I fucking hate her. And if she's a horrible voice, just to punch her. Shut up. It's deeply connected to the Japanese concept of Kotodama, the power of words. Like saying green if you want me to go harder or red if you want me to stop.
Say.
Please be silent. Yes. Please be fucking silent. I hate her. I bet your racket bends to the right too. Oh my God, every fucking word. Did they give her a single line of dialogue that's not disgusting?
Listen.
I don't think so. Please be silent forever. Exactly my sentiments. Just shut the fuck up.
Serves you right. Why don't you give it a tug with your other hand?
By the way, Mew, how were you able to get away from Gonta?
What?
Oh well. I had to use my secret woman weapon and leave it. Huh? Let's leave it at that. What the fuck does that mean? Secret woman weapon.
Typical men can't satisfy the simple needs of a woman.
What are you talking about?
Wait.
What's a secret woman weapon? Oh my God, she's. I hate this. I hate her character. I hate her. She's fucking obnoxious. Obnoxious laugh. Disgusting fucking writing of the way she says stuff. She's annoying as fuck. She insults everyone. I hate this character. Can she die next, please? Please? Watch her be the last character to survive, too. Die.
And why are we back to square one?
Because any of us could still be the culprit. Jeez! You flunk out of TARD school or something.
That's a very offensive thing to say. You can't say that in modern days anymore.
Are you a functional retard? I have to ask.
I guess I should have known a dumb whore pig like you wouldn't understand.
Oh my god! So he's insulting her back. She's been insulting everyone the whole game. Now he insults her back in the most more disgusting thing.
Who you calling a dumb pig?
Jeez. Fine. I'll explain it to the itty-bitty pea-brained bitchlet.
A pea-brained bitchlet? Where did they even get these insults from?
A bitchlet!
Anyone who doesn't get this is just as stupid as the whore bitchlet over there.
Oh my god, man.
What? Why the heck were you in your underwear, Mew?
The question is, why? Well, how was she in her underwear? She fucking ate weirdo.
You know, I'm pretty stacked, so...
What?
I figured I'd take my clothes off, so Gonta would be too flustered to touch me.
Oh my god, really?
That's my story, and I'm sticking to it, you cockroaches!
I don't know about this. It sounds like bullshit. Oh my god.
I think the blood rushed to both of Gonta's heads, because he got super embarrassed.
Stupid.
Moon was in her underwear, and Gonta got weird feeling. So Gonta ran away.
Well, he's gouging his eyes out.
Goddess, it's
Jesus.
Only natural to want to flaunt it. I show my panties to the boys all the time.
I hate this fucking character. I hate this fucking character with a passion.
So you're welcome, Gonta.
I wish you was the fucking murderer.
During your next tug session. You bet it's long enough. That's what she said.
Every fucking time she opens her mouth, it's like someone punched me in the dick. I hate it. Okay. So no, Carl Cheery says, why do they over-sexualize young lasses in the game? I don't see the point in high schoolers walking around in bikinis in the game. It makes me uncomfortable because the guys all wear normal clothes. Because, ladies and gentlemen, it's very simple. All right? It's very simple. This game is for a certain audience and demographic. They're trying to attract a certain type of guy or girl who like that kind of sexualized content, right? Now, the game doesn't have any nudity or sex in it. At least, up to this point, Danganronpa has never gone that far. But, to me, like, I feel like they are trying to attract a certain person that likes that. You know what I mean? Like, there are certain people who buy Grand Theft Auto games because they know that there's sexual content in it. As stupid as that sounds, there's definitely a demographic of people out there that will literally buy that game because it has that in it. There's a demographic of people who will buy Danganronpa games because, it has the waifus in it, right? That's why. That's what I feel. I feel that that's exactly what's happening in this game, all right? Now, some people buy this game because they like murder mysteries. That's why I'm enjoying it. I like the murder mystery aspect of it. It's intriguing and interesting. I don't really care for the anime-ish design of the characters. I don't care for the over-sexualization of certain characters. I certainly don't care for the kind of attitude and language Mew has, which is obnoxious as fuck to me, okay? But it's fun when you get to the points where, there's a murder. Now we got to figure out how it happened and, you're doing all this investigation. That's fun. I really like that. So it's kind of a mixed bag for me, but I do overall, I enjoy the franchise. As crazy and wild as the plot is. Okay? Okay, ready? Here we go. I heard a strange sound. I looked for a source of the sound. My eyes went with unbelievable sight. Oh, my God. Here we go.
Man,
I told you.
You're really plugged up. You're practically throbbing.
I told you.
Throbbing with dust and
debris. Oh, my God.
Mm-mm. This is no good. No good at all. You must feel so...
And this is so stupid because it's all meant to be sexual innuendo when in reality it's not sexual at all. It's dumb.
You've been neglecting my needs ever since I got here.
Relax.
So stupid.
I'll get it all out. Trust me. You'll be much better afterwards.
Oh, my God.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Your chassis is firm. Really firm.
This is like ultimate fucking cringe. This is like nails on a chalkboard cringe.
Seriously incredible. I've never seen one like this.
Careful, be gentle. That tickles.
This is amazing.
Oh,
whoever
my
put
God.
You together definitely knew what they were
look,
doing.
And look how bad they drag it out. Look how bad they drag out the scene. On purpose to fucking make you uncomfortable and cringy.
You definitely know what you're doing, too. If you keep this up, I just might.
Oh, my God.
So that's the sound you make when I touch that spot.
Oh my god. All right, is it over? I closed the door without a word. Oh my god. The clothes are like, oh my fucking god. What did I get myself into with this fucking game? Mew was just doing maintenance on Kibo's body. That's all it was. Indeed, nothing but that. Mr. Hurdy-Gurdy Man Sock Cheer says, you imagine your mother tuning in to see what her darling son is up to. Yes, that was the moment when 10,000 grandmothers all decided to tune into Dark Side Phil streams for the very first time. Ooh! Oh my god. Anyway, Shirtless Mofo Chudy says, are you into, oh, here we go. Are you into android sex? Oh my god. And here you go, Mr. Hurdy-Gurdy Man Chudy says, does it remind you of your first embarrassing childish sexual stumbles? Yes, you guys, all right. Let's all get it out of our systems now. Let's get all the stupid crap out now. So we can enjoy the rest of the stream, please. Everyone get the nonsense out of your system now. If you're gonna say something stupid, say it now. I can't blame you. The game fucking did something really dumb. Okay? Timbo Slice Tree said, this is what people in Japan enjoy in their anime. Right, that's what I mean. Like, it's catering to a certain demographic of people. You see? It's catering to a certain demographic that they think that was funny or interesting. Like, for me, it's cringe. But the thing is, I think also they know for certain people that's going to be cringe. So they're going for that with the writing. But, oh my god. The student council cannot ignore that. It seems we must tighten our control. Tighten? Are you calling me loose? Oh, shut up. Diversions?
Listen up!
Yup, the culprit used wax dolls to distract us from something.
Got a minute?
What do you mean?
What?
How would I know? Isn't that Sherlock Homo's job? Oh my god, now she's making homo jokes. Like she's a 5-year-old. I want to watch some faggot insult some homo. Anyway, you're a waste of time. I agree. Rag or something. Here we go. Oh my god, shut up. You're obnoxious. I hate you. Angie made the wax dolls. The resemblance is pretty uncanny. They say the devil's in the details. Let's see how detailed these really are. You tried to look up the wax figure's shirt? What are you doing? Stop that!
What?
I want to see if it's wearing panties. Why? Do you have a doll fetish? What is wrong with her? Throw her out of this room immediately! She's not gonna fucking get any. I've had it with this character. She doesn't help with anything. She's a fucking disgusting, perverted bitch, and I want her out of the game. When does she get murdered? Seriously. Can we just fucking. Can we pile books in front of her door so she can't get out? Can we just, like, you know? Can we lock her in her bathroom? Fucking take a blowtorch, fuse the door closed so she can't come out? I'm tired of this. She's a waste of space. She really is a waste of fucking space. Jesus Christ.
You and your fucking lies. Go sit in the corner and play with yourself.
Okay, I'll start right now.
That's not the reaction I expected. What the fuck?
You, I can't hold it up anymore.
What? Oh my god, alright, no, this is disgusting now. It's talking like a dick.
What's the matter?
Come on.
You going soft on me now?
Who made the locked room mystery doesn't matter since anyone could have done it. Don't you even understand something as basic as that, you filthy dumpster?
Wow, why are you. This is nasty now. This fucking dialogue is getting disgusting, man. They gotta stop with this, man. Like, seriously, that's fucking. That's over the line. Right there.
Finally! Someone finally called me a cum dumpster!
Oh my god.
What should we talk about now?
It's disgusting.
Hey, where's my things? I'm the one who installed that function into Kibo!
Hey, yeah! What was it you were saying about its purpose?
Oh, to be honest, the purpose of that image recording function is to monitor my health. Specifically, I make Kibo use that function every day to analyze my turds.
All right, everyone, have a good night. I'll see you next week for another session of Danganronpa V3. Okay, no, I guess we'll continue. Good Lord.
You what? Why?
Shit is a great indicator of intestinal health and gut bacteria quality. Plus, taking a satisfying shit does wonders for a woman's natural beauty, so... See? You're all grossed out! This is why I didn't want to tell you about my plan!
Quit talking about your poop. No one cares.
Rock the Ice has done a super chat and says, you know this will be your favorite part. No. I don't think so. Okay.
Then go and tell Carrie Himiko to her room.
Make sure you focus real good on your back, you hear me?
Oh my god.
You'll need that focus if you want to feel her little mosquito bites poking.
Oh my fucking god.
Gonta is a gentleman after all.
Fucking Miyu. Hate her. Detest her. One of my least... But the most hated character of any video game in the last 10 years, probably. There's nothing more depressing than an unnoticed prank.
Oh, I see.
I'm not reading it. I'm seriously not reading it anymore. I refuse. It's like, here, it's like a dunce who makes up stupid sexualized humor that's not funny because they want to be accepted, but in reality, they just feel so self-conscious about themselves, they think that they have to be over the top and risque every word that comes out of their fucking mouths, but instead, it's just unbearably cringe. Ooh! Oh, sorry, I broke the fourth wall there, Miyu. Ah. All right, let's continue. The classic carrot and stick approach, no one can work a carrot or a stick like Daddy. Screw your carrot and your stick, give me whips of chains all the way. Oh my god. Why did I read it? I figured me and the twins could swing by and pay your virgin ass a visit. Got a boner yet. Jesus Christ, she's disgusting.
Booyah!
Come to the computer room on the fourth floor of the academy. But there's no rush. If you want to rub one out while you're thinking about me, you got time. What a nice thing to say. What the fuck is wrong with this person? I'd be like, how about this? I'll go to the fourth floor computer room. You just don't fucking be there. Because I hate you so much. I personally detest you as a character. I don't ever want to have any dealings with you ever again. Just seriously, fuck off. I hate this. I want to punch the wall every time she opens her fucking mouth. She's so fucking nasty and just obnoxiously gross. Jesus fucking Christ. What a fucking... Ugh. Now I wrote $1.30 again for absolutely no reason. Look at that. This fucking character distracted me so much, so annoying, I can't even fucking type. Look at this. I'm so angry.
Oh, well, excuse me. I'm sorry. My feminine wiles are so distracting.
They are.
To you as a man.
This is a man zone. This whole room is a man zone. I spray it with musk every night.
Well, then guess what? This down here can remain a man zone.
It is a man zone, too.
Yeah, well, guess what? There's never going to be a woman in that man zone now. Ever. For that.
I'm not reading anymore. I was going to pretend like she doesn't talk. How about that? You're saying stuff, and all I hear is brruh, 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 brruh. That's what I hear.
Don't worry. That's what I hear when you talk, too.
Fucking virgin.
Don't act all depressed because you didn't get to spend any alone time with me. Here we go again. Why did I read that?
But
it's a world that Monokuma created, right? If you don't want to dive in, you can just dip the tip. Oh my god, shut the fuck. She's so disgusting. She is fucking disgusting. She's nasty. She's gross. She's vile. Every fucking word out of her mouth pisses me off because it's so nasty. She's fucking disgusting. I hate it.
Booyah!
Follow me if you want to peek up my skirt. Go for it. Oh, wow. No one wants anything to do with you, Miyu. You're a disgusting individual. No one likes you. You're not attractive to anyone. And you can go fuck yourself.
Seems
Seriously? It's colder. Avatars can feel cold. Yeah, isn't it great? Not only can you feel cold, you can even feel pain and pleasure. In fact, you don't even need to use birth control here. Oh my god. I don't wanna fucking play with this character anymore. I'm done with it. I can't take it anymore. I'm losing my mind. I'm so annoyed by this person. Like, it's actually annoying me to play this game further because of this character. Try to be quiet. I feel like you're more talking, more I'll dislike you. You feel like that? Really? I can't imagine why anyone would feel like that about this character. I can't. You're so fucking stupid. You're pushing Savant. I'm not even saying the rest of that. Pwn, where's Miyu? Something happened to her. What do you mean?
Well,
we're not sure, but her avatar isn't moving. Uh-oh. Maybe something happened in the real world that's preventing her from moving it. Oh, she's dead. Someone crushed her, slit her throat. It's gonna be something disgusting. Watch. Her head is on a pike.
Ah.
When I opened my eyes, I could see only black. I was logged out. The helmet on my head was blocking my vision. When I realized that, I quickly reached up to grab the helmet and pulled it off. When I did, a nauseating sight was waiting for me. All right, that was not the sight that was waiting for him, but that was equally nauseating. Here we go. A nauseating sight was waiting for me. Prepare yourselves, everyone. Here we go. What? Huh? What is it? Mew's cold, dead body? It wasn't clear what happened. It wasn't clear what killed her. What happened? Live and let the languid world live. Yeah, what happened? We have no idea. Right?
Now then.
Wow, I get to bring you the body discovery announcement live. Doing it live is great. Better than beer and fucking. What? Anyway. I thought we were done with this crap with Miyu, and then he has to say something stupid. Anyway, let's continue. What the fuck, man? Daddy, why have you always had such a potty mouth? It's a good question.
Hey,
I was holding back because we already had one vulgar cast member. Now it's my time to shine. Oh, come on. Come on. I thought we were free of it. Now he becomes like Miyu. Oh, come on.
Okay.
Now, please save your arguments for the class trial. In the meantime... Ta-da! The Monokuma file. With this, you can even investigate Up Miu's asshole. I actually read that. Why are you being so cheery about? Oh, what are you being so cheery about? Well, what are you sad about? You guys hated her. Not as much as you hate me, but still, I can't speak now. What is going on? I can't speak! Mr. Minecraft just wanted to tip me $1.30 and said, some people I watch make jokes about Miu's death, but what do you think of her death? I think it's unfortunate, obviously. Listen, she's an insanely disgusting, rude, over-the-top, sexualized character who always compensated for her shortcomings by thinking... that if she made jokes about being attractive, or she said some disgusting, crude thing, that she would be in control of the situation. It was obviously a personality flaw of hers, and that's what made her act like that, right? But overall, was she a bad person? I mean, she was disgusting, but was she hurting anyone? Was she actually, you know, going out of her way to not help the others? No. In fact, multiple times during the playthrough, she was a key factor. She was the one who had that drone to go around and collect evidence. She was the one who gave Kibo those light up eyes, right? She's had these key things that she's done during the course of the playthrough that have advanced the plot. So in reality, she actually was an important part of the plot. However, she was just obnoxious. So I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, I won't miss her obnoxiousness. But it's sad that anyone died. I mean, she's not a real person, but you know what I'm saying. It's sad that any character in the game dies. I'm not going to sit here and say, oh, I'm glad she's dead. That's completely fucked up that anyone would say that. Anyone who does say that is a psychopath.
Wow.
Ew, that's when Grody Faze Mew suffered a lot. The vulgar death fit for a vulgar bitch.
Hey!
Stop, Kokichi. Even if you're joking, it's just too far.
It's nothing.
You're right. You should never speak ill of the dead, no matter how much you hated them.
Right?
Even if she was a despised, pathetic, dirty, cum toilet of a person. Can we stop with this now? She's dead. Hey, Mew's dead. Hooray!